established. This becomes an imperative in the view of the positive steps in motion of repealing and amending of the Access to Information and Protection of Privacy Act, which is at an advanced stage. Parliament, therefore, now sits at the center insofar as aligning media laws with the Constitution is concerned. Honourable members, ladies and gentlemen, I will not waste much of your time in outlining the committee's achievements in media reforms to date, because I know that you are already familiar with the achievements of the committee. However, there is need for enhanced awareness of the critical role of the media in the realization of our vision 2030, which must be informed by a robust media sector so that the populace can intelligently appreciate the vision's developmental intended impact. Without access to information, media and broadcasting services, our development efforts as a country will stagnate. Honourable members, ladies and gentlemen, I sincerely hope that we will all invest our energies into the core business of this workshop. It encompasses topics such as overview of the legislative framework and understanding the importance of media regulation from the regulator, just to mention a few. I certainly believe that the cross-fertilization and pollination of ideas at this workshop will lead to enhanced awareness of media regulation and Parliament's mandate and how it interfaces with the executive and the media. I wish us all constructive and fruitful. All of us will be active participants. I thank you. Tino Tenda, Siyabonga, Siyabonga.